Welcome to the Mobile Money Nation. My name is AJ, and today I want to talk about a simple term that many beginner investors need to know or may have heard of, and that word is diversification. According to Investopedia, diversification is essentially a risk management strategy that mixes a wide variety of investments in one particular portfolio. This diversification can include choosing multiple asset types, or when specifically talking about stocks and investing in companies, then diversification would mean investing in multiple companies and companies that do totally different things. And so if you think about different asset types, one asset type could be a stock, and then real estate would be a different asset type, bonds would be another asset type, and even investing in art or other things considered alternative investments. And specifically thinking about stock investing, which is the main theme for a lot of the videos that I speak about on my channel. Even if you're just investing in stocks, you can invest in healthcare, you can invest in technology, you can invest in grocery stores. There are so many different sectors and industries that you can invest in. That way you're diversifying the investments or the companies that you invest in when you're purchasing stock. And in addition to investing in different industries, you can also invest or diversify by investing geographically. So if you're investing in the United States, you can diversify by investing in Europe or countries in Africa or countries in Asia. And studies have shown that all you need to have is a range of about 25 to 30 different stocks in different industries and sectors in order to have a well-diversified portfolio. And so since my channel focuses on investing in stocks, I'm going to talk about ways that you can diversify by investing in the stock market. And so the least diversified you can potentially be is by investing in an individual company that only does one main thing. And so one industry that has been in the news a lot lately because of the global pandemic are airlines. And so if you were to invest in an airline and their main way, their main source of income is based on people traveling from place to place. So whether you're traveling for work or whether you're traveling for vacation or to visit a family member or a friend or whatever the case may be, these airlines make money whenever you get on an airplane and you travel from one city to another. And so with the global pandemic going on, a lot of airlines have lost a lot of money because people aren't traveling, because they don't want to be in an airplane when there are people that could spread coronavirus and get them sick, and you're in this tight space to where you have to be close to a lot of people. And not only just considering when you're in the airplane and you're in close contact with other people, but if you were to either drive yourself and now you have to go to the parking garage where you're gonna leave your car, or if you were to have someone to drive you and drop you off, or you're taking a taxi or you're taking an Uber, there's so many different touch points just getting to the airport. And then once you're in the airport, you have to go through security. There are multiple touch points there where you may have to print your ticket or you have to check in your bags, going through security, going to a restaurant. Once you check in your ticket, once you're actually getting onto the plane, and then you have to sit next to someone. Someone may be in front of you, someone may be behind you. And then once you get off the plane, now you're at another airport and you have to go through essentially the same thing all over again. And so there are so many touch points where you could get infected by another person that's infected on the plane or someone that was on the plane previously. We don't know how well they're cleaning the planes to make sure that you're not getting the virus just by sitting in a seat, or maybe you have to use the bathroom while you're on the plane. There are so many different things that you have to think about, which is why many people aren't flying, whether it's for personal reasons or it's for business. And so companies in the airline industry have lost a lot of traffic from people not flying. And so over the course of a couple of weeks or maybe just a month, airlines as a whole have dropped about 60 to 70% of their stock value just because of knowing that people aren't gonna fly. And while recently a lot of airlines and other companies in the travel industry have gained back some of their value, as the economy has opened back up, the amount of people traveling still hasn't gone back to its original level since this pandemic started or since it has spread to America. And so there are other companies like grocery stores to where, despite what's been going on with the pandemic, you know, traveling on an airplane isn't as essential as buying food to eat. And so grocery stores have stayed open. Many of the grocery store stocks and companies that you can order food and companies where you can order food online or even have food shipped to you, they have actually done really well because people still have to eat. And so if you only had all of your money invested in airlines, then you would have lost a lot of money versus if you own stock in airlines and grocery stores. So some of that hit that you would take from losing in the airlines, that risk would be reduced because you also have stock in a grocery store company. Or you have stock in a company that sells items online and that can be shipped to you so that you don't have to go out to the grocery store grocery store, or you don't have to go to a big box store like a Walmart or a Costco. You have options in order to keep yourself safe by not going out into the public, but still being able to get the things that you need in order to eat, in order to take care of yourself, et cetera, et cetera. And so companies like Amazon, where you can essentially buy just about anything on Amazon, you can buy anything from books to food. You can essentially buy a tiny home if you wanted to. And also for businesses who haven't been open and haven't had their offices open for people to meet in, a lot of companies have started moving to the cloud. That way, some of the services or the meetings that they've had, they can continue to have those meetings and be able to work even if they don't have their physical offices open. And so that's a way you can actually diversify. Even if you're only buying one company, you could purchase the stock of a company that has many different ways that they make money. And so even within that one company, it is diversified itself. And so buying different companies in different industries and different sectors of the economy is one way that you can start to diversify one company at a time. And so a way that you can increase your diversification is by buying more companies in different industries. And so one easy way that you can do that by buying just one asset would be investing in an ETF. An ETF is an exchange traded fund. I also have a video where I go into detail about ETFs, and so make sure you check that out. But essentially, an ETF is a single stock or asset that you can purchase on an exchange. And that single asset holds multiple different stocks. It could range from anywhere from tens to hundreds or even thousands of different companies in different industries if you choose. And so, for example, you could actually buy an ETF that has all healthcare companies. So whether it's a biomedical company or a company that does health insurance, there are multiple different types of companies within the healthcare industry, but you could own all of healthcare related companies by buying a healthcare ETF. And the same goes for technology. You can buy an ETF that only invests in infrastructure for technology or only for applications within technology, or you can invest in all of the technology companies by investing in an ETF like the Vanguard Technology ETF with the ticker symbol VGT. And so you can do that with multiple industries: healthcare, technology, real estate. If you want to invest in individual industries, whichever one you feel that will grow over the long term, as long as you're investing 5, 10, 20, maybe even 30 or 40 years from now. And the way you can maximize your diversification as far as investing in stocks would be to invest in an ETF that invests in all of the publicly available stocks. And that will be a total stock market index fund, like Vanguard's version, VTI, which is their ETF that invests in all of the stocks that are publicly available in the stock market. And so that would be the way that you take the least amount of risk while maximizing the amount of diversification that you can have in the stock market. And not only that, but with the total stock market index fund, that is the standard that many professional investors are actually trying to beat. That index fund, as well as the S&P 500 index. And so if you can just buy that index fund, whether it's the total stock market or the S&P 500, you're actually beating 80 to 90% of professional investors who actually aren't able to beat the market over the long term. And so you're reducing the risk of investing in an individual company or multiple individual companies that you have to actually do the research and know more about to make sure that you're investing in a good company. Or you can just invest in all companies, whether it's all companies in the S&P 500, which gives you a little bit over 500 different companies, or investing in the total stock market index fund, which invests in thousands of different companies that are publicly available. And so not only are you saving time by not having to research individual companies, you can automate this so that you're investing in the total stock market or the S&P 500 consistently every week or every month for the long term, and you're still beating out 80 to 90% of the professionals without needing to pay a professional to invest for you. And this is the best way to go for many beginner investors, beginners who don't totally understand how the stock market works, or beginners who don't want to spend that additional time in order to do the research to purchase any individual stocks and know when it's time to sell or when it's time to buy more. And so remember, diversification is all about reducing the risk of losing your money or having a lower return over the long term. And so if you want to have the least amount of risk while also beating 80 to 90% of the professionals when you're investing in the stock market, diversifying your investments by investing in an S&P 500 index fund or total stock market index fund is the best way to go. And so be sure to check out the playlist Investing for Beginners so you can watch more videos just like this where I talk about basics of investing so that you can get started investing today. Thanks for taking the time out of your day to watch this video. If you're not a current member of the Mobile Money Nation, all you need to do is hit the subscribe button down below, hit the like button because you really like this video, and also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I create a video. Again, thanks for watching. Have a great day.